Star Trek The Clone Wars, the greatest Spaceballs movie ever made. Spoilers ahead, by the way. Hey, it's been a while. I got married and stuff, but I'm still alive, and I am committed to reviewing all the Star Wars movies and shows. Here's the thing. The Clone Wars was doing baby Star Wars characters before it was even cool. Now, if you're going based off the movie, it's pretty bad. Ahsoka is annoying. Baby Jabba. Enough said. However, it launched a series that would go on to become the greatest Star Wars content ever made. And I'm not being sarcastic this time. In fact, as annoying as she is at first, Ahsoka goes on to be one of the greatest characters in Star Wars. Now, the first few seasons have a lot of fluff. In fact, some of the episodes are just plain bad. Jabba has a redneck cousin with a creepy girlfriend whose mom is a guy.
I got trouble for you too.
Okay.
And it's pretty dumb. But stuff like this is few and far between and only in the early seasons. And don't get me wrong, some of the fluff is good. It makes the clones actual characters, like they have individual personalities and you care about them, which is pretty cool. It makes Anakin an actual character, like he actually has a personality and you care about him, which is pretty cool. Plus, there's R2-D2 and C-3PO adventures, which are great. Jar Jar gets interrogated by General Grievous, but don't get me wrong, this show is not all fun and games. Towards the fourth season, stuff starts to get real. It's amazing how much this series elevates the prequels, no pun intended. Like, it brings Darth Maul back with a vengeance, introduces us to a doomed romance between Obi-Wan and Mando Lady, just to have Maul kill her right before Obi-Wan's eyes. Yeah, they're not playing here. Season 6 explains a lot of stuff as far as the inhibitor chips and how the clones went from being the Jedi's buddies to mindless slaves during Order 66. There's one arc where Anime has to dump Anakin for a while because he gets a little too aggressive with an ex-boyfriend. And don't get me started on Ahsoka's arc at the end of Season 5. She gets framed for bombing the Jedi Temple, Anakin tries to help her, she runs away to figure it out on her own and ultimately is proven innocent. But not until after the Jedi Council has already removed her. They offer her a spot back on, but she's got some trust issues at this point, and she leaves. But first, we get this exchange.
The Jedi Order is your life. You can't just throw it away like this. Ahsoka, you are making a mistake.
Maybe. But I have to sort this out on my own. Without the Council. And without you.
I understand. More than you realize, I understand wanting to walk away from the Order.
I know.
Credits roll, no music. Yeah. See, the reason this is so good, because it makes Anakin's eventual turn in episode 3 not feel so abrupt. Like, we see this turn start to happen, and honestly, how the Jedi Council did his Padawan, it's a pretty understandable motivator for trusting them even less than he already did. Now, the last four episodes of the show are so stinking good. It ties everything together so beautifully. Ahsoka is with Anakin and Obi-Wan moments before the beginning of episode 3, and she has to go off on a mission to capture Darth Maul, which makes him not the throwaway villain, no pun intended, that we all thought he was in episode 1. Plus, seeing Order 66 from Ahsoka's perspective, man, it's heartbreaking. And to see just how much she's grown from the beginning of the series to the finale is just awesome. She embodies the ultimate message of Star Wars that the later movies try and fail to capture. But we'll talk about that in another video. Ultimately, the message is the Sith and the Jedi are both wrong. You as an individual have to decide whether you're going to use your abilities for good or evil. And I think that's awesome. Now for the elevated part of elevated entertainment. Let's swap the Force with faith for a second. I know that while my faith community is super important, and that there are absolute truths, sorry, Obi-Wan, When faith is institutionalized and turned into religious fundamentalism, it does more damage than it does good. At the end of the day, you have to own your faith for yourself. Not have a priest or a Jedi Master decide for you, but really interact and wrestle with these big questions on a personal level. So, yeah, anyways, 10 out of 10. See you next time.